Thank you. Be seated, please. We are gathered on this day to witness and to celebrate the marriage of Keaton Moore and Sierra Waddle. We come together not to mark the start of a relationship, but to acknowledge and strengthen a bond that already exists. This ceremony is a public affirmation of that bond. And as their dearest family and friends, it is our honor and privilege to stand witness to this event. This day is made possible not only because of your love for each other and the grace and support of your family and friends, but by the grace of God. It is our hope that your fulfillment and joy in each other will increase with each passing year, and your love for God will stay abundant. With that, I ask, who gives this woman to be married to this man? As a minister, I have the joy of being a part of many wedding ceremonies. I get to sit down with the couples and hear all about how they met, how they fell in love, and how their lives have been changed through their love for one another. There we go. In our meeting, I had the honor of meeting Keaton for the very first time a few months ago. And he impressed me as a man that loved the Lord and loved Sierra. Kudos to his parents for their godly influence upon his life. I have known Sierra and her family since the day she was born, and have watched her grow all through her life as her dedication and faithfulness to the Lord was strengthened by her commitment to various church activities. Kudos to her family as well. Marriage is a commitment to life, to the best that two people can find and bring out in each other. Marriage offers opportunities for sharing and growth that no other human relationship can equal, a physical and emotional joining that is promised for a lifetime. Within a circle of love, marriage encompasses all of life's most important relationships and adventures. A wife and husband are each other's best friend, confidant, lover, teacher, listener, and encourager. Marriage understands and forgives the mistakes that life is unable to avoid. It encourages and nurtures new life, new experiences, and new ways of expressing love through the seasons of life. When two people such as Keaton and Sierra pledge to love and care for each other in marriage, they create a spirit unique to themselves, which binds them closer than any spoken or written words. Marriage is a promise made in the hearts of two people who love, which takes a lifetime to fulfill. Let us pray. Father, we are so grateful that you, the creator of heaven and earth, love us, care about us, and listen to our prayers. Lord, we ask that you bless Keaton and Sierra today and every day in their marriage. Help them to keep you as the foundation of their lives and to love one another in good times and bad. We ask all this in the name of Jesus. Keaton and Sierra, I charge you both as you stand in the presence of God and to remember that covenant love alone is sufficient as the foundation of a happy and an enduring home. Let the Apostle Paul be your teacher who wrote in 1 Corinthians 13, love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, and it does not boast, and it's not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking, is not easily angered, and keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth, always hopes, always perseveres, and now these three remain. Faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. It's easy to see that Keaton and Sierra do love each other, but really, what is love? Love is quite a common word. We use it in many ways. We say, I love you, to the person we care about most in the world. But we also say, I love chocolate. Certainly, we do not love our significant other the same way we love chocolate. Yet, we have no better word to express ourselves. So what really is love? As we heard in 1 Corinthians 13, love's patient, love is kind, and forgiving, among many other things. Love means being all these things, but notice that it is not about a feeling. We don't fall in love and out of love. We fall in holes and out of trees. Most people, when thinking about love, think about the emotion, the romance of falling in love, and the desire to share every moment and learn everything about this other person. We think this kind of love we see in movies that usually end in a wedding like this. But love is far more than emotion. Emotions are fleeting. They are here one moment and gone the next, and anyone who's been married longer than a day knows that the feeling comes. Marriage is not easy because true love is more than a feeling. It's a choice. Sierra Keaton, if you want your marriage to be strong and to last, you must choose every day to love the other. If you choose to do this, your marriage will be one of the most fulfilling, rewarding, and fruitful parts of your entire life. The perfect example of love is found in Jesus, who sacrificed everything and humbled himself by taking on the form of man, coming down from heaven to earth and to die for us. He chose to give up his life so that all who believe in him could have it. Jesus' sacrifice was out of his great love for us. There is no greater love than to lay down your life for one another. In the same way, my hope is that you, Keaton and Sierra, that you would lay down your lives for one another. That is, giving of yourself to the other in the same way Jesus gave his life for you. Keaton, each day, choose to love Sierra by putting her desires ahead of you. Sierra, each day, choose to love Keaton by putting his desires ahead of your own. This feeling of your wedding day will eventually fade. And in those moments, you must choose to love. I'm going to ask you a series of statements and questions. And if you agree with me, simply say, I do. Keaton, I'll begin with you. Keaton, do you take Sierra to be your lawfully wedded wife, to be a considerate, tender, faithful, and loving husband, to support, guide, and cherish her in all that she does, to thoughtfully and carefully enlarge the place she holds in your life, to constantly show her the tokens of your affection, to shelter her from danger, to love her in sickness and in health, and to love her with an unchangeable love, to keep yourself only for her as long as you both shall live. Decision, or was that predetermined?
Predetermined.
Predetermined, all right. I'm glad to hear that. Sierra, do you take Keaton to be your lawfully wedded husband, to be a considerate, tender, faithful, and loving wife, to comfort, guide, and cherish him in all that he does, to continue making the place he holds in your heart broader and deeper, to support him, value him, and to love him in sickness and in health, to love him with an unchangeable love, to work with him to make your marriage the very best that it can be, and to keep yourself only for him as long as you both shall live? Remember that in every marriage, there are good times and bad, times of joy, times of sorrow. The vows you're about to take are not to be taken without careful thought, for in them you are committing yourself exclusively to one another for as long as you both shall live. Marriage is a journey, a time of adventure and excitement enhanced by the love, trust, dedication, and faith you share in one another. May the promises you make to one another today be lived out to the end of your lives. Tomorrow can bring you the greatest of joys, but today is the day it all begins. If you would please, join hands, face each other. I'm going to say a phrase. Keaton, I'm going to begin with you, and if you will, repeat after me, please. As we make our public commitment to one another, I, Keaton, take you, Sierra. To be my lawfully wedded wife. To have and to hold from this day forward. For better or for worse. For richer or for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Until death do us part. I make this promise to you before God. That I will be true to you by His grace. Trusting in Him. So long as we both shall live.
Allergies.
Sierra, repeat after me, please. As we make our public commitment to one another, I, Sierra, take you, Keith, to be my lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, until death do us part. I make this promise to you before God, that I will be true to you by His grace, trusting in Him, so long as we both shall live. May I have the rings, please? Thank you, sir. Wedding ring, as we know, is a symbol of eternity. It is an outward sign of an inward and spiritual bond which unites two hearts in endless love. Its never-ending circle symbolizes a commitment to this marriage that will end only when life on earth ends. Those who see these rings on your hands will recognize that you too have made a commitment. The rings will remind you that you have pledged to each other today, before God and in our presence, a commitment that will transcend the differences, selfishness, and inevitable difficulties that families encounter. And now, as a token of your love and desire forever united in heart and soul, I ask you, Keith, to take her ring, place it on the third finger of her left hand, and repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol and pledge.
As a symbol and pledge.
Of my constant faith.
Of my constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
I have for you.
I have for you.
Sierra, would you take this ring, please, and place it on Keaton's third finger on his left hand, and repeat after me. I give you this ring as a symbol and pledge of my constant faith and abiding love I have for you. Today, the bride and groom have chosen to braid three strands together into a single cord. Each strand has a significant meaning. In Ecclesiastes 4, the Bible tells us that though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves, but a cord of three strands is not easily broken. The cord of three strands represents God, the groom, and the bride. Keaton and Sierra, the two of you will braid these three strands, symbolizing the joining of one man, one woman, and God in marriage. In braiding these three strands together, Keaton and Sierra have demonstrated that their marriage is more than a joining of two lives. It is a unity with God as well. They have chosen to allow God to be at the center of their marriage, woven into every aspect of it. By keeping the Lord at the center of their marriage, His love will continue to grow and bind couple together. For as much as Keaton and Sierra have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and all who are assembled here and have pledged their faith to each other and have declared the same by joining hands and by the giving and receiving of a ring, therefore, according to the authority vested in me by the laws of this state and as a minister of the gospel, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I have the honor of presenting to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Keaton Moore.
Give me a sign, I'll give anything to make your mouth hide. I'll give you a big, big, big. Friday.
Y'all made.
All right, Jason, ready? One, two, three. Daddy, hold her hands. There you go. Okay, there you go.
Muscle sweetness?
Yeah. Don't get any over here on this pad. Give her a hug, Dad.
She's not coming.
Oh, she's gone.
It's all over his jacket now.
Come here.
You're seriously not, are you?
Get his letters in the truck.
Okay. Hey, fill me. Fill me. Fill me. Fill me. Sierra, you look very beautiful. Okay, stop. Oh.
Their letter, then. I guess so.